Hello everybody, welcome to the JavaScript course. In this video, I'm going to discuss f.prototype. f.prototype is referring to a property that refers to the prototype of an object that is created by a constructor function. So here, f means a constructor function. And I'm also going to discuss the default f.prototype if I have not set up any of the prototype explicitly. Now, this is the HTML file, which is quite simple. I have a title and a heading. And this HTML file is linked to a JavaScript file called myscript.js. And this JS file is stored in the JS folder. In order for me to use the strict mode, I just say use strict on the first line of my JavaScript file. And then I'm going to discuss the f.prototype. f.prototype means a property that refers to the prototype of an object, which is created by a constructor function. So the sentence is a bit abstract. That's why I'm going to use an example to explain this idea. Now, I have an object called dessert, and this object has one key value pair. And then I have a function called cake, and I have set this color equals color. So that means I'm going to pass a value whose parameter is called color, and then I can make use of this function to create an object. So if I want to create an object from the function, it means that this function is really a constructor function. So if I want to create a constructor function and I would like to set the prototype of this object coming from the constructor function. So in general, a cake is a kind of dessert. That means I can say that the cake has a prototype called dessert. So in order for me to set up a prototype of a cake which goes to dessert, I can have an idea like this. I can just say that the cake.prototype goes to dessert. And the cake.prototype is the f.prototype issue here. F is a constructor function. Now the constructor function is just the cake function. So now I have set up the relationship between a cake and a dessert. And we say that the cake has a prototype called dessert, which is an object. So I'm going to link a function to an object by using the f.prototype approach. And then if I want to set up an object from the cake function, I can do something like this. Okay, you can see that I have set up a new object called strawberry cake, and the strawberry cake just comes from the constructor function called cake, and I passed a value called pink so that the color of the cake is just pink. How can I access the properties from the strawberry cake object? Let me show you my way. Now you can see that I have to show two alert windows. So one is the sweetness property of the strawberry cake, and the other one is for the color of the strawberry cake. So let me run the program. Save. Reload. Yes, the sweetness is just light coming from the dessert object. And the color is pink because I just get the parameter from the constructor function. So you can see that the strawberry cake is having a sweetness of light level. That means the strawberry cake has already inherited the properties from the prototype called dessert. Okay, so I just use this approach called f.prototype to achieve the linkage between the cake function and the dessert object. Also, I'm able to check the prototype more appropriately. I can have something like this. So now I just want to see whether the prototype property of the strawberry cake is the same as the prototype of the cake function. So let me see. Save. Reload. Yes, it is true. So cake.prototype is just the dessert, and the strawberry cake.proto is just the same called dessert. Okay, the other topic is called the default f.prototype. If we haven't set up the f.prototype explicitly, what will happen? We can see the description here. If we have not set up any f.prototype, the f.prototype is just an object with the constructor property. So for example, if I have set up a certain function like this one, the constructor is just a function, and this becomes the prototype of that particular function. So every object created from this function would have the prototype which just points to the function itself. So how can I verify this point? Let me show you the way. Now I have set up two alert windows. The first one is to print out the function.prototype, and the other one is to print out the function.prototype.constructor. So save, reload. Yes, the first alert window gives me the object. That means the prototype is just the object type. And the second one gives me the function itself. That means when I want to see the constructor of my person.prototype, it just refers to the function itself. So I will have the function showing up here, including the content inside the curly brackets. Of course, my function has nothing included. That's why I would have a pair of curly brackets. Now the person function has nothing inside. If I want to add some property to the default f.prototype, how can I do it? Let me show you my way. Suppose I want to set up the person.prototype by adding a Keyfinder pair. So I can do something like this. Person.prototype.language equals English. So the language property has a value called English. If I want to show it out, I just use the alert window. So let me save it and reload the page. Yes, you can see that English has come out. That means I have set up a key value pair to the person.prototype. Let us go to another situation. Suppose I want to set up an object from the function first. So now Alice is just coming from the person function. So Alice is now an object. If I want to create an object that has the same constructor as another object, how can I do so? Let me show you my way. I want to set up another object now. In this way, Bob would have the same constructor as Alice. And how can we check it out? We can see the way here. Before I run the page, I have to comment out the things first. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see that the constructor for Bob is just the same as that of Alice, because I set up Bob as having the same constructor as Alice does. Since Alice is just handled like the default f.prototype, it means that this object would have the constructor which is just pointing out to the same function that Alice is coming from. Okay, so we can see that the constructor value here shows the function that Bob is based on, and Bob is also based on person function like Alice does, because they share the same constructor here. Okay. And in order for us to understand the connection between different objects, we can just use the console window to take a look at the relationship. So how can I do it? Go to more tools, web developer tools, and then I can open the console. If I want to check this strawberry cake, I can do something like this. And then I run the console.log command. Yes, you can see that the strawberry cake has a prototype called object whose content is sweetness.light. That means the strawberry cake would have the prototype coming from the dessert object. You can see that the dessert object also has this key value pair. So that's why we can see that the linkage is established. And this prototype refers to the higher object class, which has helped us to inherit many of the built-in functions for objects. And how about the other case? How about doing the Alice situation? You can see that Alice has come out, and Alice would have a prototype which links to the person function, because you can see that language equals English is something about the person.prototype shown here. Okay. And let me check, the constructor is just the person function, which is a constructor function, of course. We build Alice according to the constructor function called person, so we can see the relationship quite clearly. And for this prototype, we have the key value pair showing that the language is just English. And how about Bob? We can see that the prototype is just a person function, which has a key value pair called language equals English. And of course, the constructor function is just the person function that is used to create the Bob objects shown here. Okay. Of course, the constructor is the same as that for Alice, because they both come from the same function called person. So this video has already discussed many things about the f.prototype. When we go back to the beginning, we can see that we can just set up the prototype pertaining to a constructor function. We can see that we can set up a prototype for a function that is going to help us create an object. And then we can also handle the default f.prototype, which shows the constructor function being this function itself. Also, we are able to see the linkage by using the developer tools, by clicking on More Tools and Web Developer Tools. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.